Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Wilmar Balbuena. I'm going to report the critical evaluation and promotion of local and oral history, chapter 10. Museum in the Philippines. Museum has a big role to play in the process of education. Not only allows people to experience the culture, but create also the cultural background in their society. Because museum nowadays is also an institution responsible for cultural activity, organizing also institutions, activity organizing concerts and exhibitions. The first museum development is the Aguinaldo Shrine. The Aguinaldo Shrine is a national shrine of the Philippines. Declaration of independence from Spain was declared on June 12, 1898, araw ng Clayang or Independence Day. The house now is a museum. The shrine is ancestral home of Emilio Aguinaldo. The house was built in 1845, made from wood and thatch, and reconstructed on 1849. The second is the Ferdinand E. Marcos Presidential Center. The Ferdinand E. Marcos Presidential Center is a museum situated in Batac, Ilocos Norte, dedicated to former Philippines President Ferdinand Marcos, which also hosts the cenotaph of the former president. The museum shows memorabilia of the late president from his stint in the armed forces down to his presidency. The large cenotaph, which contains the glass and encased coffin in which the widely believed inbred body of Marcos was on public display shortly after his remains were brought in Ilocos Norte from the United States in 1993. Until his body was reinterred at Balibingan ng Bayani in Taguig on November 18, 2016, a wax replica of Marcos remains to be displayed inside the glass of coffin. The third is Yu Tangkoy Santos House, also known as the Museum of the Woman of Malolos. An early 20th century bahay na bato structure along Petri Street, formerly Electricidad, in Barangay Santo Niño in the city of Malolos, Bulacan, in the Republic of the Philippines. The home belonged to Pauline Santos and Alberta Yutangoy Santos, revered for her contributions to the Philippines woman rights, the fight for Philippine independence. Yutangoy Santos House has been declared a National Heritage House by National Historical Commission of the Philippines. The museum currently uses collections of surviving artifacts and other memorabilia relevant to narrative of women, and the Yutangoy Santos family house was built and completed in 1914 after the original 1819 structure was destroyed by a fire in 1919. The Yutangoy Santos house is currently owned by Sofia Santos Tibayan and Lourdes Santos Herrera, granddaughters of Paulino Santos and Alberta Yutangoy Santos, under care of non-profit organization the Woman of Malolos Foundation, INC, which is spearheaded in efforts of restoration through their own A Piece of History, Adapt a Heritage House project. On April 14, 2013, the house turned into a museum, opened its doors and public through a soft launch that was attended mostly by members of the Women of Malolos Foundation and descendants of the 20 women. For the results from the production of original two-story Spanish colonial style in Calamba, Laguna, where also was born on June 19, 1861. Regarded as one of Philippine greatest heroes, Jose Rizal definitely made a big mark on the Philippine history. In the city of Calamba in the Laguna province, a reconstruction of his old childhood has become a big touristic attraction. Jose Rizal was a very intelligent playmate that Filipino that lived during the late 80s. He was ultimately executed by the Spanish for the crime of rebellion. Rizal was a leading force and influence during the Philippine Revolution that ultimately led to the Philippine independence on September 29, 1898. Jose Rizal was born on June 12, 1861 in original story Spanish colonial house in the Colombo, Laguna during World War II. Rizal's original house was destroyed but was rebuilt at the same site on June 19, 1950 with Rizal's original belongings kept in the beside the shrine. Rizal's can room the house freely. Original or related trivia are written in the walls, rooms, and carefully constructed at represented the way they used to be when Sirisa used to live here in the late 1880s. The culture of the Philippines. The culture of the Philippines is characterized by cultural diversity. Also, the multiple ethnic groups of the Philippine archipelago have only recently established a shared Filipino national identity. Their cultures were all shaped by the geography and history of the region and by centuries of interaction with neighboring cultures and colonial powers. In more recent times, Filipino culture has also been embraced through its participation in the global community. Among the cultural ethnic groups of the Philippines archipelago, the Negritos are generally considered as the early settlers citation medium today. Also, few in numbers, they preserve a very traditional way of life and culture. After those early settlers, the Austronesians arrived on the archipelago. The Austronesian's culture is strongly evident in the ethnic majority and language. The advent of Spanish colonial rule in the island marked the beginning of the Philippines as an entity, a collection of Southeast Asian countries united under Spanish Empire. The Empire ruled via the Viceroyalty of New Spain and later directly from Madrid after 1821 Mexican independence. The island between the 16th and 19th century, Batanes being one of the last places to colonize in the mid of 1800s, resulting in Christianity to spread and dominate through the archipelago and influence the religion and beliefs of the natives. Then the Philippines became a U.S. territory for almost 50 years. Influence from the United States is manifested in the wide of the English language media and the modern culture and clothing of present-day Philippines. C. Architecture. Bahay na Buto is an example of architecture. It's a traditional Filipino house. Before the arrival of European colonizers, Austronesian architecture was the common form of housing on the archipelago. During the Spanish era, the new Christianized lowland culture collectively involved a new style known as the Nipa Hat, Dahay Kubo. It is characterized by use of simple materials such as bamboo and coconut as the main source of wood. Kugon brass, nipa, palm leaves, and coconut frogs are used as roof thatching. Most pre-painted homes are built on stilts due to frequent flooding during the rainy seasons. Regional variations include the use of thicker and denser roof that chain in the mountain areas or longer stilts on coastal areas, particularly if the structure is built over water. The architecture of the other indigenous people may be characterized by an angular wooden roofs, bamboo in place of lily thatching and ornate wooden carvings. The Bahay Nabato architecture is a variant of Nipa Hag that emerged during the Spanish era. Spanish architecture has left an imprint in the Philippines in the way many towns were designed around a central square of the Plaza of Mayor. But many of the buildings bearing the influence were demolished during World War II. Some examples remain mainly among the country churches, government buildings, and universities. Filipino colonial architecture can still be seen in centuries. Old buildings such as Filipino Baroque Church, Bahay Nabato House, schools, convents, government buildings around the nation. The best collection of Spanish colonial era architecture can be found in the walled city of Intramuros in Manila and in the historic town of Bagan. Kalesa. Kalesa is a traditional Philippine urban transportation in front of Manila Cathedral entrance. They have been proposed to establish a policy which each municipality and city will have an ordinance mandating all construction and reconstructions with such territory to incline with the mostly of city architecture and landscaping styles to preserve and conserve the country dying heritage sites which have been demolished one at a time in the past years. Urbanization, cultural development, and lack of townscape architectural vision. The religion. There are many kinds of religion in the Philippines, such as Christianity in the Philippines, Catholic Church in the Philippines, and Christianism in the Philippines.
Good afternoon, I'm Calvin De La Cruz. I'm going to report the Cathedral Vision and Promotion of Local and Oral History in the Philippines. The arrival of the Spanish colonists in 16th century brought the beginning of the Christianization of the Philippines of people in the Philippines. This piece in history is noted as a coming point for the destruction of a variety of artist beliefs in the country, which replaced the colonial belief system that filled the states of the Spanish, notably Christian beliefs. Christianity in the form has influenced Filipino culture in almost every facet, from visual arts, architecture, dance, and music. Recently, the Philippines is one of the two predominantly Catholic 80.58% nation in Asia Pacific, the other being past Timor. The century also has its own independent visual art. Early pottery has been found in the form of mostly anthropologists, earthworm jars dating from E5 BC to 225 AD. Early Philippines painting can be found in a rich leaf clay mixed with water designs embellished on the ritual pottery of the Philippines, such as Lamanagar. Evidence of the Philippine pottery making stated as early 6000 BC has been found in Sungasanga, Cavite, Sulu, and Cagayan. F. Indigenous art. These Italian people are known for their intricate wooden fabrics. The binnacle is the blanket which furnish design that incorporate optical illusions other parts of highlands in the Caroline region of their local term Calogatan displays their art in training weaving bags like the sangs, a traditional bag. Many Filipino painters were employed by chefs and started using materials such as extract from onion, tomato, tuba, coffee, and rust molecules, and other materials available anywhere as paint. The Lumad people of Mindanao, such as the Bulan, Mandalaya, Mansaka, and Tibuli, are skilled in the art of dyeing abaca fiber. Abaca is a plant closely related to bananas, and its leaves are used to make fiber known as Manila shrimp, and the fiber is this wide method called tekat. intricate fiber are woven into cloth with geometric patterns depicting human, animal, and plant themes. Coat cloth is a technique combining society, Oriental and European art process, considered loose art and highly collectible art form. Very few known as species exist today. The technique was practiced by the indigenous people of Samar Island between early 1600 and late 1880s in the Isokte Philippines art form based on the early century techniques. In caustic and layering, the emerging ancient styles produced a used technique artwork characterized by delicate sweating in foreign lights. High performing arts dance. Philippine folk dance include the Tiniklin and Carinusa in the Southern region of Mindanao. Singko is a popular dance showcasing the story of prince and princess in the Paris. Bamboo poles are arranged in tic-tac-toe pattern in which dancers float every position of this clashing pole. B. Music. The early music of the Philippines featured a mixture of indigenous, Islamic, and variety of Asian sounds that flourished before the European and American colonization in 16th and 20th centuries. Spanish settlers and Filipinos played a variety of musical instruments including flutes, guitar, ukulele, violin, trumpets, and drums. Many Filipino musicians have been raised from sons such as the composer and the conductor Antonio G. Molina, the composer Felipe P. De Leon, known for his nationalistic theme, and the opera singer Jovita Fuentes. Modern-day Philippine music features several styles, music genres, and contemporary such as Filipino rock, Philippine G. Literature. The Philippine literature is diverse and rich group of works that has evolved throughout the centuries. It has started with traditional folk tales and legends made by ancient Filipinos before Spanish colonization. The main theme of Philippine literature focuses on the century pre-Hispanic cultural, traditional, and the socio-political history of its colonial and contemporary traditional. The literature of Philippine illustrates the prehistory and European legacy of the Philippines. Written in both indigenous and Hispanic writing system, most of the traditional literatures of the Philippines were written during the Spanish period while being preserved utility for Spanish colonization. Philippine literature is written in Spanish, English, or any indigenous Philippine language. Key, cinema and media. Salon de Portrera was the first introduced moving picture of the January 1, 1897 in the Philippines. All films were all in Spanish since Philippine cinema was first introduced during the final years of the Spanish era of country. Antonio Ramos was the first known movie producer. He used the Lumiere cinematograph when the film Panorama de Manila, Fiesta de Quiapo, Puente de España, Bridge of Spain, and the Esquina Corregidora streets scenes. Meanwhile, Jose Nepomuceno was dubbed as the father of the Philippine cinema. His work marked the start of cinema as an art form in the Philippines. His first film produced was entitled Dalagang Bukid, film showing Rizom in 1919 during that American period. Walgraf, a British entrepreneur, opened the current Walgraf Art No. 60 Calle Santa Rosa in Intramuros. It was also during this time that a movie market was formally created in the country along the arrival of silent movies. The silent films were always revived by the romantic piano and quarter or 20-man choir. The 1950s saw the first golden of the Philippine cinema.
Hey everyone, so continue with this report. I will be discussing the cinema and media. Cinema and media. So first, let's tackle about the cinema and media where Salon de Petra was first introduced moving pictures on January 1, 1896. Film world in Spanish since Philippine cinema was first introduced during the final years of the Spanish era of the country. And during this time, Antonio Ramos was the first known movie producer. So Antonio Ramos used the Lumiere cinematograph during filming the panorama in Manila, known as Manila Landscape, Fiesta de Quiapo, Punta de España, Bridge of Spain, and Isinias Calejiras street scene. Meanwhile, Jose Nepomuceno was dubbed as the father of Philippine cinema. He was known as father of the Philippine cinema because of his work marked the start of cinema as an art form in the Philippines. His first film produced was entitled Dalagang Bukid, Country Medin, during 1919. Next, cuisine. As we can observe here in our country, we have a different varieties of restaurant, as well as foods, as well as all know that Filipinos have different styles with when it comes to cooking, and that's why we do have our own butahe. So Filipino cooks a variety of foods that was influenced by the Indian and Chinese, and we are influenced by their indigenous ingredients. During 16th century, the Spanish colonizer and fear about different ingredients which was produced from the Americas, such as chili peppers, tomatoes, corn, potatoes, and the method of sauteing with garlic and onions. Education. Next is education. So education here in the Philippines has been influenced by the Western and Eastern ideology and philosophy from the United States, Spain, and its neighboring Asian countries, wherein Filipino students enter at public school at the age of four, starting from nursery and kindergarten. And at the age of seven, students enter elementary school from 6 to 9 years. This include grade 7 to grade 10 as junior high school. Then after they graduate, since our country implement the K-12 system, students should enroll a 2 years course to prepare for their college life with their own choosing tracks. This system offer track like EBM, STEM, UMS, science, and as well as the TECBO or the technical vocational. Then after 2 years in junior high, students can either choose to take a college entrance exam, CAE, or find work after they graduate at senior high. Sports. Next is sports. Sports is popular in our country, and this become part of our lives apart from keeping them physically fit and active. Sports is also considered as their favorite bonding activity among family and friends. One of the national sports in the Philippines is Arnis. It is a form of martial arts among the most popular sports. There also includes basketball, boxing, football, billiards, chess, ting, pin, bowling, volleyball, horse racing, sepak takraw, and so on and so forth. Philippines had its own sports from its own terms, the Palarong Pambansa. It is a national sports festival and has its origin in an annual sporting meet of public schools that started in 1948. Traditional games. The next is the traditional games here in Philippines. This refers to such games like Loksong Baka Patintero, Pico, and Tumbang Preso are still played primarily as children's game. Among the youth, so one traditional Filipino game is Loksong Tinik, a very popular game to the Filipino children, where one has to jump over the tinik and cross the overside and catch. Also, other traditional games include Yuyo, Pico, Patintero, Bahay Kobo, Pusoy, and Sangka. Tong it's also popular gambling game, and these card games are popular during festivities, which some includes Pusoy and Tong it's, and being used as a form illegal gambling and mahjong played in some Philippine communities. Also, the Salagubanggang indigenous group, indigenous people of the Philippines, a group of people that were only fully annexed to the borders of the Philippines later in history, especially during the post-war modern era. Like, for example, the Ita indigenous tribe, as they are the earliest known migrants here in the Philippines. They reached Philippines because of the land breeds and